Having a hard time writing reusable code? Well, today we are going to learn about a principle that will fix just that. I'm Alex from Rebeloper.com, and if you want to learn about the fifth principle of the solid principles, go ahead, let's open up Xcode and let's dive in. Dependency inversion principle depend on abstractions, not on concretions. Now, we are going to tackle this with a hands-on example in Xcode, but let's just talk a little about what solid is and why you need to pay attention to it. Well, solid is actually an acronym for all of those five principles, and today we are going to take a look at the last principle, the dependency inversion principle. If you do care learning all the previous principles, go ahead and check out the link in the description. Now, the dependency inversion principle is about abstractions should not depend on details. Details should depend on abstractions. Now, why is it important to learn all of these principles? Because these principles establish practices that lend to developing software with considerations for maintaining and extending as the project grows. So the gist of this is that if you want maintainable code down the line, then make sure to follow all of these principles. Well, they are not kind of like, okay, you must obey to all of these principles and you must obey them all of the time. It's kind of a guideline that I like to use very, very often. Although the solid principles apply to any object-oriented design, they can also form a core philosophy for methodologies, such as agile development or adaptive software development. And yeah, Swift UI is kind of there. You do want to use Solid with Swift UI. And as you know, I really like Swift UI. So every developer should understand all these principles as it is a key concept for any software engineer. So yes, Solid is what you want to learn. Now, we are going to take a look at dependency inversion principle. Like high-level modules should not depend upon low-level modules. Both should depend on abstractions. Again, this is kind of a rephrase of the principle. Abstractions should not depend upon details. Details should depend upon abstractions. Now, let's take a look at this in an example. But before we dive into it, let me just remind you about Dev Factory. Now, what is Dev Factory? It is a 60-minute Zoom call with me. If you do want to learn Swift UI or all of these solid principles with me personally on a 60-minute Zoom call, then go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. And yeah, I can also answer your questions, or if you have a bug in your code, I can do that also. Like, we can just talk about it or maybe fix it. Who knows? Now, if you do want to win a 60-minute Zoom call with me after this video, then go ahead. This is what you have to do. This is my challenge for January. I will give out 60-minute Zoom call with me as a Dev Factory for free if you are going to like this video, comment on it, share it, and of course, you want to subscribe to the channel and maybe hit that notification bell to get notified of the next video, because in the next video, I will go through all of your comments and choose one random one. So that's about mentoring. What I'm going to show you today is this project. So if you haven't already done so, go ahead and check out the link in the description for the resources. And basically what this will give you is just a before and after file that you can drag and drop into your Xcode project. So this is vanilla. So what is dependency inversion principle? Well, I really like this one. So the last explanation, abstractions should not depend upon details. Details should depend upon abstractions. So let's see how would we create a before this principle code, and then you will see exactly why you actually need to adhere to this principle. So let's create, for example, an employee and then an employer, and let's make the employee work and the employer will manage it. So let's create our file private struct here, struct of employee. And well, basically that employee will work. So func work, and then, well, currently let's just print out working. Okay, so that's our employee. Let's create our employer next. And by the way, when you are going to take a look at these codes, they will actually work. It will not break, but Following solid principles is much better on the long run. So let's create our file private struct right over here. Let's make this employer. There we go. And this employer will have employees. So, and by the way, let me just make some more room here. It's much more convenient. So employees, and that will be an array of employee. Okay, and then let's create our function of manage for our employer. And what that will do is just go through all of the employees. So let's just have for each, there we go, and the employee, and for all of those employees, let's just go and work, employee and work, there we go. Okay, so let's create an example for this, again, a file private function, and example. You might be wondering, example, why am I doing all of these file private functions and structs? Well, we are going to kind of use the same names and function names inside the after function. So yeah, let's not make a mess out of it. So let's create our employer. So let employer, and let's have an employer right over here, and employees, and yeah, let's just create one employee right over here. Let's just initialize it, and then we just go employer.manage, and basically this will print out working from right over here. The employee is working, and yeah, this looks fine, this is okay. So you might have asked, why is this not okay? It is fine, but it is actually really, really not okay. So let me just show you how the after would look like with the dependency inversion principle really taken care of that. Okay, so let's have a little bit of space here. Again, depend on abstractions and not concretions. In our preview, the before example, we had concretions like the employee could work, the employer could manage. So let's kind of rewrite all of this. So again, a file private, and I'm going to go with a protocol, and that will be a workable. Now, if you don't know how to use protocols, or you are just new to the concept, go ahead and check out my all encapsulating video about protocols. The link is in the description. So the workable protocol should have only one function, and that is work. So whoever adheres to this protocol should implement the work function. Okay, so now let's create our file private struct of employee. So struct employee, and the employee of course needs to adhere to the workable. So let's wait for Xcode here to yell at us, and then we will just autocomplete, like fill in and all of those protocol stuff. So as you can see, it requires us to work. So adhere to the work function. So working, there we go. So now it is working, and that's it about the employee. Now you see that we are actually depending on abstraction. Now the abstraction is the workable, and whoever adheres to the workable will actually need to implement the work function. Now, let's just go and create finally our employer function. So again, file private, struct and employer. There we go, it's employer. So now let's create our employees. Now, these employees actually will be workables because, this is what we want to do. Maybe other type of workables will be under the management of our employer. So let's create our workables, and that's an array of workable. Great. And now we create our function of manage. Okay, we are going to manage, and our workables dot for each. And that's a workable, of course. And here we are going to go and use the work function of the workable. So yeah, you can see now it's really, really flexible. So let's create our example file private. Let me just move this up. Okay, file private function example, and then let's create our employer. And that's an employer. And now we need to add in here workables. Again, workables could be anything. This is the abstraction. So we are going to add our, let's see. Well, let's just create one employee right over here. I've got an array, employee. And whoever adheres to the workable protocol could be added to this array. Hooray. And now we just go employer and manage. And of course, this will also print out working and as it's expected. Again, let's recap here. So let's see the differences what we have between those two implementations. In the before, we just had these concretions. We had an employee, we had an employer who had employees, and then for all of that, they would work. So basically when they manage, all they could manage is employees. Now, the better way of doing this is to have a workable protocol and an employee, or whoever wants to adopt the workable protocol will adopt the work function and do some work there. And therefore, when we are creating an employer, we are just going to add the workables. It could be an employee or other struct that adheres to our workable protocol. And then we just manage that, employer.manage, and that will take care of making the workable work. So hopefully that is coming together for you. Now, this is the last principle in the solid principles. If you do want to check out the whole playlist, there is a link down in the description. But as I promised you in the last video, we are going to pick a winner from the previous video. Whoever liked, subscribe, share that video, and most importantly, commented on that video, will have a lucky chance, well, a chance to be drawn for, wait for it, a 60-minute free Zoom call with me. Now, the same goes for this video. Of course, if you do all of those things, like, share, subscribe, and comment, and maybe hit that notification bell to get notified of the next video where I will draw you out, then you will be able to participate on that 60 minutes free Zoom call. So let's just go ahead and take a look at the previous video. This was my previous video. And then let's just copy that out and let's pick a random winner there. So let's fetch all of the comments right over there. Okay, and now let's pick a random winner right over here. And it is Bollywood Pranks, and he said hi. That means that he, most importantly, taken a look at the rules, what they have to be inside that video, and commented and liked. Yeah, that is really awesome. Now, if you're watching this, make sure that you contact me at support@rebeloper.com, and you make that contact email with the email that you commented with. So basically the email that you are signed in to YouTube. Okay, so yeah, if you do want to win Dev Factory 60-minute Zoom call with me, go ahead and again, comment, like, share this video and subscribe. But if you're interested and you don't want to wait for it, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring where you can meet me on a 60-minute Zoom call. Finally, we have come to the end of the Solid Principles series. And if you did like this video, make sure to hit that like button. And while you are at it, make sure to hit that notification bell to get notified of upcoming videos. Now, I highly recommend that you take a look at the protocols videos. They will help you a lot in understanding the Solid Principles. And make sure to check out the playlist for all the Solid Principle videos. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.